Pray, pray, pray. I pray I make PA. I pray I make. I pray I make PA.
Vegas, Jose.
Let's go. Yo, Vegas is in Las Vegas. 11
Am I in the right place?
You're in the right place, but it's been the wrong time, Mr. Jackson.
Seismitic.
My name's Sweet Tick. It's Miss Sherman. I'm your homeroom teacher.
Don't blame me, girl. A good-looking woman like you.
Oh, Mr. Jackson, you can follow me like a stack of flapjacks, but you still be on time for class.
Oh, crap.
Enough four-letter words.
It's the hardest, 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 hardest
Introductory ballet meets first period every morning. Students are expected to arrive on time and ready to dance.
What's this, a shopping list?
Participation in the dance program requires specific attire, including tights, leotards, leg warmers, and specialized footwear.
Character shoes, jazz shoes, and point shoes.
Who do you think I am? Imelda Marcos?
Luckily, we've received a generous grant from the National Endowment to help cover the cost.
Yo, Miss Bell. I can't be wearing no leotard.
And why is that?
Because I've got a generous natural endowment.
Oh, hey guys.
Oh, hey.
Goody, this is the band I was telling you about. We got Grace.
Lamb chops. I play the drums.
Sorry. Hannah.
Actually, my name's Minsauce. We're kind of a duo. I play guitar.
I'm on keyboard. And you?
Trumpet.
Cool. How are we supposed to start a band with that?
We'll make it work.
Oh, but goody there, girls.
Yeah? Got a problem with that? Goody.
No, I like girls. I just get nervous when we've got sticks in their hands.
Oh, knock it off, guys. If we're going to be in a band, we've got to get along.
Good luck with that.
Mr. Shinecott, we'd like to work together for a freshman ensemble.
Percussion, trumpet, violin. What kind of music would you play?
New wave.
No. Sir, funk.
Classic rock.
Maybe a little disco?
We're starting a band.
That's if this guy stops jerking my chain.
Oh, it's gonna be a long year.
You can say that again.
Wait. You should see her in a leotard. Oh my god, you know Sheena, the jungle queen? Now, backity, I said, Carmen, you're not using your lips. Your mouth will burn overnight. Am I even listening to me?
Not really. I lush her somewhere between her curvaceous thighs and that cute little beauty spot on her lip.
Oh, look, man, forget about the book. A book you can replace but a pair of lips like that. You'll lose. You'll lose forever. Oh, look, man, here she comes. Hey, my little jalapeno pepper. How about we go dancing Saturday night?
How about we don't?
But you and me, we got a lot in common. In like, you're Spanish, you know I'm Spanish. You're gorgeous and I'm gorgeous. You're hot
and you're not.
See, what I tell you, man? She's crazy about me.
Excuse me? Aren't you that guy from the peanut butter commercial?
Yeah, but do me a favor, don't spread it around.
And why not? God, I'd kill to have a national commercial on the air.
You sound like my mom. She's been dragging me to auditions since I was three.
I wish I had a mom like that.
Trust me, you don't.
My name's Serena Katz.
I know. I saw you in homeroom.
Do you think... I hate to impose, but could I have your autograph?
Look. I came here to concentrate on my studies.
But why? You're already a pro. I bet you've even got your actor's equity card.
I want to be a real actor, not just some TV hack. Have you ever read Stanislavski?
Stan who?
Konstantino Stanislavski. He founded the Moscow Art Theater in 1897. His friends struggled on staff, but that was okay because they believed in what they were doing.
Wow, you're really into this.
You gotta be. The work, the craft, that's all that really matters. Listen to this. The actor must learn to use the magic if. What if? From the moment of the appearance of this if, the actor passes from a plane of actual reality into a plane of another life, creating and imagined by himself. Believing in this life, the actor can then begin to create. I wanna make magic. I want to be bigger than I am. I wanna make people really care. Really give a damn. I wanna make magic. I
want to breathe fire on the stage. I want to make every single line jump right off the page. I want to do it all from A to Z. I want to do the lion in winter, Brecht and Harold Pinter, Sophocles, Eugene O'Neill. I want to really see what I can be, another Jason Robards or De Niro. Play a tragic hero, go for it all, really show the way I feel. I want to make magic, I want to electrify the place. I want to be more than just a fool with makeup on his face. I wanna make magic, magic, magic.
Thank you, Pete, for showing what's fault. Okay, it's good to have role models, but at this point in your training, to concentrate on process, not results.
I'm sorry, I've just got so much I want to say.
No need to apologize. In my class, you get points for honesty, because emotional honesty is what it's all about. Isn't that right, Carmen?
Yeah, sure, Mr. Myers, whatever you say.
No, let's all give Nick a hand.
Yo, baby, way to go!
Joe to the front.
So, you think I should tell my girls because my, like, my personal hero is Robin Williams, man. Yo, Chico, you're the man, baby.
This time we're going to play a fair game called Truth or Consequences. I want you to share with the class a secret. Something about yourself. Something that reveals the essence of who you really are.
You mean some, like, deep, dark secret I may only tell my priest?
Exactly.
Think we're going to like this game.
Mr. Myers, what's with all this true confession stuff? Are you an acting teacher or a shrink?
A little bit of both. Human psychology is a big part of acting. Joe, begin when you're ready.
Hey, man, can I get some light up here? No? Okay, man, this is going to be painful, you see, because there's this girl I like, and every time I see her, something just comes over me. You know what it's like when you wake up in the morning from a dream. And the girl that you left there was Dana Ross, the Supreme. Oh, moving and grooving down around Times Square, hanging with your crew, feeling slick. And you're losing your mind from the X-rated posters on some flick. You go to a club and you're high.
stage fright.
I'm like what you call an extrovert.
Really?
Let's see a show of hands. How many of you believe his story? Serena, why?
Adolescent boys are immature.
How do you know?
At least that's what my mother said.
And your naysayers. Nick?
It's Vinny Joe Vegas.
How about it, Joe? Truth or consequences? Okay, man, let me try again. I'm thinking about the time in my life when I first learned what crying was. Or the first time I had to come face to face with what dying was. My relatives gave it all in black to mourn for my great aunt Juanita. But who comes through the door to pay her respects? Our cousin Conchita. The tears in her eyes only made her seem even more Spanish. As she came to me, I swear I felt the floor underneath me vanish. She goes to the mall and she finally comes over to me. As she kisses my cheek and then I lower my eyes, I can't hardly believe what I see. 'Cause I'm looking down the front of a gown and I can't, oh I can't, I can't keep it cool, I can't keep it cool when that girl's in school. I wanna rock and roll. Thank you, Joe. That was very brave, a little X-rated, but honest. An avalanche of emotions, that's what you wanted, right? It's in my head, then I need help.
Good morning, class. I'd like to introduce you to our newest arrival. Her name is Iris Kelly. We're very lucky to have this young lady with us.
Merci, madame.
All right, people, let's find our partners for the adagio.
Merci, madame? Who does she think she is? Pepe Le Pew?
Trust me, Mabel, this girl ain't no skunk.
Tyrone, put your eyes back in your head. She's so out of your league.
Says who?
Says the shiny black loan that dropped her off just before homeroom.
All right, people, let's take it from the top. Sorry, I just got hung up on the subway. Ready, and. Stop, stop! Point your toes, Sonia. You look like you're wearing ice skates. Chin up, eyes to the horizon. Keep the movements fluid. Ready, and. Imagine crystal clear water flowing gently downstream. Mabel, I said water, not molasses. What's wrong with you today?
I feel faint. I haven't had a thing to eat since breakfast.
It's only 9:15.
I don't care what time it is. My stomach is screaming, feed me, feed me.
Hang in there, Mabel. Only 3.5 hours till lunch. Okay, let's take it from the second phrase. Ready? Begin. Classical lines, people. Imagine you're dancing for Balanchine. Iris, take Mabel's place. Gently, ladies, gently. You're ballerinas, not truck drivers. That's lovely, Iris. You look like a swan queen. Carmen, Tyrone, this is adagio, not disco.
But it's so boring. And talk about uptight.
We study classic dance for the same reason we study bar. It's about technique and classic form.
think of it as a trip to the museum.
Yeah, but why does it have to be like that? Why can't we do something much different? Like, you know, switched on, tight wired, like the traffic in Times Square.
Sounds like you've given this a lot of thought.
Tyrone did more than think about it. He made up a whole new dance.
Don't suppose you want to see it?
I'm game if you are.
Right. Now remember, just like we practiced. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Choreographer in our midst.
Move over, Alvin Ailey!
Come on, Mr. Scheinkopf, we're not hurting anything.
Except your eardrums. Mr. Metzenbaum, I received a phone call off your father. He wants to make sure you practice your violin at least 3 hours each.
Oh, isn't that cute?
That is what we're about. It's pint-sized Paganini.
And who's Paganini?
A famous violinist.
I'm sorry.
Mr. Metzenbaum, I know you are eager to find your own musical voice, but may I remind you that musical genius runs in your family. Musical chairs runs in yours, Miss Lam. Now, I believe you had a Mozart assignment.
We practiced already.
Good. Let me listen. One, two, three, four. Good enough to begin practice.
All right, let's get back to the good stuff.
No, Scheinkopf's right. What would a kid raising concert halls know about rock? I'm sorry for wasting your time.
Where are you going? Back to Daddy?
Look, I'm sorry we wasted your time, but this band thing, it's never going to work.
It will work, Slow-mo.
Good, good. Almost good enough to begin practice.
Let's rock!
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
basic. It's ridiculous.
I'm trying. Can't you see that I'm trying?
You don't support me in the Attitude Promenade. You dropped me out the Arabesque Settee.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't speak French.
These are technical terms. Every dancer knows them.
Not me. Down in my neighborhood, we both move to hip-hop. How are you going to say that in French? Besides, it don't matter how much I practice my cavaliers.
Cavaliers?
I still don't have no future in ballet.
Maybe you would if you tried harder.
Hey, I try as hard as anyone. But to be honest, when was the last time you saw a brother in the crop to ballet?
What does race have to do with it?
Maybe you haven't heard. Blacks can't cut ballet, because our bodies are all wrong for classical dancing.
It's not your body that's the problem, Mr. Tyrone Jackson. It's your attitude.
Hey, screw you, Iris. You and that silver spoon you keep shoving down my throat. Don't need no rich snitch to tell me which foot to use. I pay my dues in the rock trap city, called New York. Living off beans, greens and pork in the basement, tenement. No one gonna tell me what it meant to be black, jack, ace of spades. The car wash, washing than the day we're made. Can't wash it off, it never fades. It's who you are until you're dead. Then ain't gonna kick upside your head. Yeah, I know about Pryor. I'm pointy, eh? Can't get higher than the sugar rays. Muhammad Ali and Dr. J. I've got 90% of the NBA. Reggie Jackson. Jesse Jackson.
Michael.
And Nahalia Jackson. And what's that gotta do with me? On the street, the only thing I see is crack dealers, pocketbook dealers, drug owners, Times Square daughters, 8-year-olds who dance with quarters, toques and two-line blows, you Adidas and stereos, that's us, that's it, so don't be giving me all this.
Tyrone, wait! Daddy's not rich. They barely have enough money to keep me in point shoes.
Yeah, right. That's why your dad drops you off every day in that long black limo.
My father's a chauffeur. He drops me off on his way to work. And I don't speak French either.
Then why have you been putting on this act?
Because I was scared.
Scared of what? You're like the best dancer in the school, Iris.
Scared no one would like me. Tyrone, I've never done anything but dance. Never been on a date. Never had a boyfriend. Never been kissed.
Well, maybe I can help you with that.
Maybe we can help each other.
Settling an argument.
Well, the next time, try a handshake. Oh, by the way, you owe me a book report. 500 words on my desk tomorrow morning.
You got it, Miss S. Hey, Iris, I don't suppose you've read How to Kill a Mockingbird, have you?
Are you kidding? It's my favorite book. It's all about this lawyer named Atticus Finch and his crazy neighbor called Boo.
Fried chicken, potato salad, and candy bars? Girl, are you gonna eat all that? I've tried every weight loss program known to man, but I always go back to the seafood diet.
What's that?
I eat food, I see food, and I eat. It's a joke, Carmen.
I'm laughing. I am laughing.
Anyway, what's your secret? I've never seen you pick out once.
That is the beauty of diet pills. Handful of uppers for breakfast, and I'm good to go all day.
Girl, don't you know them things are bad for you? And I don't mean good bad. I mean bad bad.
Why, what is to worry? I'm young, I'm healthy. I'm gonna live forever. Yo, Mr. Myers, I need to be excused from class on Friday. You see, they're doing a revival of West Side Story, and I'm like the perfect role for Anita.
I'm sorry, Carmen, but the last thing that you need right now is another character to hide behind.
What's that supposed to mean?
Carmen, you know the first rule of acting is to know thyself. If you don't learn to deal honestly with your own emotions, you're just going to be another pretty little face that no one cares about.
You're wrong about me, Mr. Myers. Hey, I'm going to make it, because I got what it takes. From now on,
to worry about. Me, myself, and I. I mean, one day you're gonna see my name up in lights. Carmen Diaz. I'm talking Broadway, movies. People are gonna shiver when they see me coming.
Shiver, honey.
Shiver. They'll say, there she goes, Carmen. Not the movie, not the opera, but the real life human being. There she goes, and she's a picture of a real life star. You wanna follow her, whoever you are. And there she goes. She's passing you. Better hurry if you wanna look. Maybe you'll get her in your autograph book. She's passing you. Reach out to touch, don't be shy.
Talent. I have more real talent than all of you put together. You have your Hackney conventions, have us first and foremost place in art. Go back to your charming theater and play your miserable, worthless plays.
I have never acted in such plays. Leave me. You're nothing but a Kiev petty bourgeois. Nick,
I don't like this scene.
But The Seagull is a classic play.
Classic schmassic.
And Madame Arquette is a great role.
I don't want to play your mother.
Okay, how about Shakespeare? A comedy? Maybe Two Gentlemen of Verona.
And which one would I play?
Would you stop being so difficult?
I'm not being difficult. We just spent a whole year investigating our emotions, and you keep picking scenes I can't relate to. Why can't we try something different?
Like what?
Like Abelard and Eloise, or Troilus and Cressida, or Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. I would just die to play Maggie the Cat. I have a copy in my bag.
What's this?
You gave it to me last semester.
You carry my headshot around?
Yeah. I mean, no, I meant to leave it home. No, Nick, don't, wait.
For crying out loud. How am I supposed to get any work done if you're acting like an adolescent?
What's wrong with acting like adolescents when that's exactly what we are? We always seem to be sister and brotherly. It's such a lovely way to be. And I want to say what it means. I know, though I never could show how it kept right on growing. The way I know I really feel about you, the way I know I'll always feel about you. Why can't we? Why can't we? Why can't we try to play?
Maybe you should find yourself a new scene partner.
And I want to say what it means to me, how I could never be the same without you. Something more that I know, though I never could show how it kept right on. I really feel about you the way I know I'll always feel about you. Why can't we? Why can't we? Why can't we try to play a love scene? We don't need the violins to play a love scene where we see how love begins. We can find a start and play it from the heart, a perfect scene from a play unknown. Let's play a love scene of our own.
You come in.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. A genius at work, right?
Hardly a genius.
Shlomo, your problem is you don't have enough confidence. Like that piece you play all the time. Solid gold.
It's for sophomore composition. I've been working on it for weeks, but I feel like something's still missing.
Here, take these. They're lyrics. I want them to go with that tune. Go ahead, check them out.
This isn't a song, it's a sonata.
What difference does it make? I know a top 10 hit when I hear one.
You really think so?
Guaranteed to go platinum like that. But I guess you hear this stuff all the time. Compliments and stuff.
Are you kidding? I come from a family full of perfectionists. Nothing I do is ever good enough.
Hey, I hear you. I could win a Grammy and my mom would still call me at disappointment. So you want to take him for a test drive? The lyrics.
Oh, yeah.
Bring on tomorrow. Let it come. Let him know that we're there. Let him know we know where we're coming from. We can make a difference. It's not too late. Bring on tomorrow. We can wait.
That's really good.
Thanks.
No, really good. Except for the second and third lines. They just don't flow.
Oh, okay. I see what you mean. Wanna try it again?
Sure.
Bring on tomorrow. Let it shine. Like the sun coming up on a beautiful day.
It's yours and mine. We can make a difference. It's not too on tomorrow, we can wait.
You're unreal.
You're crazy.
I'm crazy. I just struck gold. Don't you see? We're good for each other, Shlomo. I mean, I want your bad needs.
Sure. After all, we just wrote our first song together.
Oh, man, you are too much. I'm in the band. All right, look, I gotta go. I've got an audition, but I'll catch you later.
Yeah, catch me later.
Oh, you got it. You definitely got it. And I got you.
Goody, we're rehearsing.
Yeah, for what?
Good news, Carmen's gonna be in the band.
Shlomo, now we've got 3 chicks in the band. And one of them don't even play an instrument.
We'll give her a tambourine. And anyway, we need our lead singer, so that's it. Case closed.
Ooh, testy, aren't we? Hey, Shlomo, come here.
What?
I said come here. Give me a kiss!
Strong, like fire and ice. Let's take it again from the top. Hello, Esther. What brings you to the fourth floor?
I understand you chose to feature Tyrone and Iris in the Junior Festival.
They earned it. Iris, wash your arms.
Well, unfortunately, Tyrone won't be able to participate.
Say what?
I'm sorry, Tyrone. You failed sophomore English.
You flunked me. But I did all the work. I even handed them a turn paper on time.
Well, your paper bore a remarkable similarity to Iris's paper.
Hang on. Are you accusing me of cheating?
Tyrone and I studied together. So what if the papers are similar?
They weren't identical.
Hang on. Then why did I accuse Iris?
Because she's always been a straight-A student. Tyrone, let's face it. Iris has been carrying your academic subject this entire year.
Nobody carries me. I do my own work in my own way.
You may think you do, but your reading is substandard. There's no way you could have written that paper.
Forget this noise. Didn't want to be in the festival
Tyrone,
anyway.
Tyrone, wait.
He's made his decision, not going to live with it.
You're not being fair, Esther. Tyrone works hard in my class. He's motivated in my class. He has the potential to be a true artist.
Oh, a true artist that can hardly read. Let him pay a fastest academic search. Then we'll talk about his future in the arts.
No, we'll talk about it now. Artists are special celestial fools, blessed with a talent for breaking the rules, and fit for confinement in cubicle schools.
for me to credence, they have to be given the chance to fly by the seat of their pants, to develop their minds, and make that should like pass. I, as a part of the same human race as everyone else in the same bloody place, they've learned to survive when they fall on their face. Artists or not, Greta, you know that 90% of these students will never make a living in the arts. We have to prepare them for life. Oh, what's Tyrone gonna do if he can't make us a dancer?
Muff floors! Tyrone will make it.
I've seen them come and go for all these years. Kids with no time for anything more than carrying in space. Another year, another ship lands. Back in the tribe, on the style, on the basic equipment. This one is different. And I can see.
In summer school, then maybe you can participate in the festival next year.
Don't be doing me no favors. I don't need the school, and I don't need you.
Tyrone, wait!
Greta, he's made his decision, and now he'll live with it.
You really think I'd let Tyrone just walk away? After everything I've invested in him? Obviously you don't know me very well.
You all knew the conditions when you enrolled here. And nobody said it was gonna be easy. You have to do what has to be done to get the job complete. And now we go on. Everyone back to work. Everyone back to work!